Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. On this episode, I'm going to introduce to you a splendid Persian palace known as Chehel Sütun. So stay tuned. Chehel Sütun Palace is one of the historical buildings which dates back to 400 years ago and is located in Isfahan city. This place, which has a floor area of 67,000 square meters, was built during the reign of Shah Abbas I. The pavilion in the middle of the garden, which formed the main part, has several sections, including the central hall with 20 pillars and adjacent rooms. During the reign of Shah Abbas II, the building was completed and in the central building, general changes were made, including adding the Hall of Mirrors, the Hall of 20 Columns, the two large rooms north and south of the Hall of Mirrors, the porches on the sides of the Royal Hall and the large pool in front of the porch, with all of the decorations like paintings, mirroring, and tiling of walls. At first, there were paintings instead of mirror tiles, but after the palace caught on fire and when it was reconstructed, silver mirrors were used on some parts of the porch ceiling. The central hall of the palace, which was reserved for foreign guests, contains paintings that express the historical events of different eras. This magnificent hall, which is based on an engraved dome with colorful, golden and shining designs, is considered one of the artistic masterpieces of that epoch. Chehel Sütun Palace is the main mansion inside the garden and was built in 1647. According to an inscription that was revealed from under the plasters of the building, the porch of this structure is composed of two parts. One of them is based on 18 tall wooden columns that the middle four columns are placed on four stone bases which their carvings looks like two lions and a human head. The squirt of water in the middle of the hall from the mouth of four lions located in the four corners of the pool and the stone fountains in the small creek path around the palace have given this place a special serene mood. The other part is a little higher and it's called Hall of Mirrors. This part is placed on two columns and all over it is decorated with extensive and elaborate mirror tiles, in which small and delicate mirrors are used in a mosaic form. The ceiling of the porch is also embellished with various paintings that are enclosed in elegant wooden frames with different geometrical shapes. The image of the marble pool in the middle of the porch can be seen in the ceiling decorations. Chehel Sütun Garden has three entrances that the old one is facing east. When you enter the garden from its main entrance, after sauntering a short distance, you will reach the large pool in front of the pavilion. Chehel Sütun Garden has a very slight slope that helps the water stream flow in the garden easily. In the past, the water flow of the garden was supplied from an aqueduct, but currently it's supplied with water from a deep well. Vegetation of Chehel Sütun Garden currently consists of pine, elm, black maple, and sycamore trees. In the gardens around the palace, seasonal flowers have been planted, which are grown in the greenhouse on the south side of the garden. The floor area of the palace is 2,122 20 square meters and the site of the mansion is 1 meter higher than the level of the garden ground. The architecture of this palace is a combination of Chinese, Iranian, and French designs. The building consists of a large porch with a length of 38 meters, a width of 17 meters, and a height of 14 meters, which was built towards the east. The columns of this octagonal porch are made of plain and pine wood. The paintings in the central hall of the palace, some of which were done in the Qajar era, describe the reception of Shah Abbas I and II and Shah Tahmasib of princes of Turkestan and India, as well as the war of Shah Ismail I and the Uzbeks. Two other depictions, one facing the entrance of the hall and the other in front of it, show the Battle of Chaldoran during the reign of Shah Ismail I and the Battle of Karnal during the reign of Nader Shah Afshar. These two artworks were painted in the early Qajar era. On both sides of the colonnaded hall, there are rooms that are currently used for seasonal exhibitions. These rooms also contain pictures, some of which are considered pièce de résistance of painting. Most of these murals were hidden under a layer of plaster, which were brought out and restored with the help of experts. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comment section. And if you like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.